What's up, y'all? So it's your girl Ishatuna at Ittb TV. Right now I am in the truck, loaded up. Today's Sunday, June 11th, and I am about to go up to Cincinnati to the International Supermarket.
2023, here we go yet again. Stomping on you bitches like your motherfucking friend. Sound kinda crazy, it's the closest in the end. Keep something tucked, 380 in the wind. Square the bitch once, 20 rounds, get the M. Staying real humble, ain't give me what I want. Gotta pop my shit to take what I'm owed.
Bro, that is hell. That is not rain, that is hell. What the hell? Whose storm is this? What storm is this? I feel like a storm chaser right now. Alright, y'all, we made it. It's raining. Oh man, it's raining. The rain I thought that should have started a little earlier. I'm getting it now, for sure. But we made it. We here. We made it safe. Hydroplane a little bit on the freeway. And it was like when I got closer to here. So I was like, oh, that puckered up my butthole. But I'm going to turn the camera around. Like, look at this. And I thought the church. So this is one of the things that I like about
the church is big as hell.
Areas is that a lot of them are a bunch of shopping center, like they have shopping center areas everywhere, right? And all of their roads is damn near expressways or freeways. So if you ain't got no good car or nothing like that, I don't know how good they, if they have a bus system or what. But look at this. Hold on. Like, look at that. Jungle gym. Alright. I ain't gonna record too much out here because we're gonna record on the inside. And here we go. Because the rain is breaking the rain.
Yo, y'all. It was so much to record on the inside. So, there's a lot of points where I'm just doing voiceovers. Plus, the music is playing. And it felt like the music got louder as I went through the store. So, it kind of sucked. But as y'all can see, like, look how big this store is. This ain't even, it's like a mall for food. And this is just the food section. They have different section. They have a produce section. They have a candy section. They have cheese section. They have a dog section. They have a book section. You know those collectibles that you can get from a bookstore? Like, it's so many sections in this store. And I was stuck in the first part of it for a good bit of my trip. So, what am I doing here? I had got me a little ad or whatever to kind of check out their deals, which I never did. I knew I wasn't going to really be buying a whole lot. It was just kind of like an exploration day. Yeah, I was checking out their produce, which took me a minute to find. I only think I have a lot of footage of the produce section because I'll recording and actually trying to enjoy the experience was kind of difficult. So I recorded as much as I could or as much as I felt like I should in the first couple hours, first hour and a half maybe. And then after that, it was pretty much like a power walk through the rest of the store. Like, I was like, I looked at my watch and I was like, oh shit, I've been in this section for over an hour. Let me go and kind of pick up my pace. So I kind of started putting the camera down. As you may catch, I'm in the protein section and their fitness supplement section. I'm pretty impressed. They had some stuff that I had never seen before.
This is dope. Look at this. Smokables. Hookah.
They got the hookah on deck. This is like the, I don't want to call it this, but the Oriental section. But it's like, it wasn't just the Oriental section. See, it's like Middle East. The, Germany. What else? India. But I felt like I was in the Oriental section, or like the Chinese, Japanese section. One thing that stood out to me.
Germany.
They got that German honey.
German honey. That is sick.
But one thing that stood out to me. I'm gonna start talking whenever I hear there's a bunch of music.
Y'all, like, it is so much stuff in here. Like,
my senses were going crazy. Overflow.
I found a
care section.
Toothpaste.
The herbal black charcoal toothpaste.
Face. No, it's for your face.
They
natural
had a face. That's a face mask.
For skin. That's soap. Soap.
Different kinds of soaps. Like, it reminded me of, like, you know, and it's just in sections. Like, every section was almost set up like this, where each country or culture had, it had the foods, but it also had lifestyle products, care products.
There's so much stuff.
So much stuff. Deodorant, shampoo. So much stuff, and a lot of it is still processed. I looked at the ingredients on the back of it. I went crazy when I saw the incense, but I was like, nah, don't let me go crazy on incense. So my objective when I was selecting stuff to purchase was to buy things that I don't come across every day. I come across incense all the time. Yes, I did buy some noodles, but I never had these specific kind of noodles. They got soft really fast when I did the review too. They soaked up that water like no other and expanded it, but it was like really soft. Y'all know I've been in my yoga. Been on my yoga groove. So I saw mats, and it's actually prayer mats, but
a prayer rug.
If I had got it, I would have used it as a yoga mat. And then this is what
holly powder
got me. It's actually colored powder.
No, it's powder.
Like, if you ever do a color run, that's what that looks like. I've never done a color run, but I know what the powder looks like, and that's what that looks like. But they have so much stuff that you wouldn't even think of.
Clay pots.
There was a back section of this that I didn't even look at.
Super, super amazing. And I only been in here for like 10, 20 minutes.
It was 10 minutes at that point. I literally just walked through the door.
They have a lot of masala. What does it mean to be masala?
Please answer that. What does it mean to be masala? Now, I didn't buy anything from the freezer section because a 2-hour drive, I didn't want anything to unthaw and melt. But I saw like a lot of YouTubers do the mochi, the ice cream mochi, and I actually bought some mochi. But I didn't get any of the frozen, anything from the frozen section because I didn't want it to unthaw. I was saying if I bought anything from that section, I'd probably have to eat it in the parking lot. Hurry up and eat it. And, I mean, I was fasting this day, too. So, that's why I was avoiding trying to buy stuff that I would have to eat in the moment. But, like, look, they got every section labeled. Every section labeled. Asian. Edamamas. You see the edamama sign? And like the other thing that stood out, y'all see the elephant on top. Like on every aisle, every section, they had different kind of artifacts just chilling out for it that represented each section. I thought that was cool as well. So that is another reason why I definitely want to come back. And I was saying, everybody eat a glizzy. Every culture has some glizzy. So y'all better eat them glizzies. All right, so noodles, man, pasta, and they weren't.
No, these are jelly.
What is that?
Mung bean sheet jelly.
Mung bean sheet.
I think these are
rice noodles.
These are rice noodles, garlic crayfish flavor.
But ramen, was in every section. Like, I got ramen out of the Indian section. It was in the Mexican section. It was in Chinese, Japanese.
Fungus strips.
Yeah, they're going to say, get y'all right with them fungus strips.
Mushrooms, dried mushrooms. Okay.
But, like, this was a sight to see, man. And I'm so grateful that I was able to make the trip and made the trip. Again, I got so excited. This is a bigger tea section. This was the biggest tea section in the store. Like, it's super huge.
Some expensive ass tea.
Yeah,
too.
It was pricey.
Shit.
Yeah.
Damn, my white balance is
trash. I think it was like, how much is it?
I say $10 now.
$10 for a can of that.
$12,
$11.99. $12 for that can. And it wasn't that big of a can.
These are German candies. I didn't
learn
know
something new every day. All right, y'all. So the music, again, it was getting so loud. But this is the fiery food section. And you know it turned me up. Oh my god, like y'all gonna hear
oh
the music in
god.
This too.
Yes, this looks so hot.
But it like super
hell
hot.
I got Grippo seasoning though.
And then I don't know what happened to the video, but at the top there were different nasty word hot sauces that they were trying to hide from the kids.
And a lot of hot stuff. And then the music.
Like, yeah, like I don't know who this is, but yeah, they was. Like, I heard how loud the music sounds
like,
now compared
so
to the earlier
crazy.
Video. It's crazy. I ended up muting it because didn't want to get copyrighted. And then, like, I've been saying this a lot, too. Never tried it, but they got that slap your mama. Tastes so good, make you want to slap your mama. All right, so that was all the footage that I caught.
Success. Too bad this shit cost me $56.99. The watermelon was $8.99. Big ass watermelon
huge, y'all.
and AC.
I got 2 gallons of watermelon juice from one.
Like I said, y'all, I am a bit hungry right now, but
I ended up going to Home Depot as well. But they didn't have what I was looking for, and I didn't record in there either.
I'm going to go get something to eat. I think I'm going to stop at the Lowe's or the Home Depot. I saw one and see how much they're... I need a lawnmower
wheel.
They
didn't have it.
And I brought my lawnmower wheel so I don't have to go back to the store when I get back to Louisville.
Just go home.
So... And then I'm going to have to, I'm going to pull over and message my clients about the schedule this week. Because it's 12:19 right now.
I was multitasking.
Trying to leave the area around about 1 o'clock. Like within the 1 o'clock hour. 1:30, something like that. I have to pee as well right now. That store is super huge. Oh my God, it has a section for everybody, and I'm gonna tell you guys a lot more about it when I make it back home. They playing a lot of music. They was playing
Whitney Houston
up in there, and
oh my God,
I'm gonna share that with y'all. They got literally they have a section for everybody. I didn't record every section. They have a Berea. Somebody is here from Berea.
That was my undergraduate.
And they got an Indiana plate.
Alumni.
Wow.
School.
Wow, that's so crazy.
I don't think I ever met anybody from Indiana. That's why I was like, oh snap.
My white balance is so off right now. And it's
y'all can't see it. White balance was horrible.
I'm not trying to get they plate either.
I tried though.
I can't get it. But that car right there. As Berea plates.
I don't know why I was shocked. Shoot, Berea be getting people from everywhere.
It's so crazy.
I thought
man.
The train was dope too. Like the idea of having like a safari themed train.
They got the monkey in around. But again, I'll let you guys know.
I did
more
not know this was zoomed in on my face.
And what I picked up at the store outside of the watermelons, man. I have to come back.
Itching like crazy.
I will come back. I'll be back. Just imagine living in this area. Imagine living in this area and having the opportunity to come and grocery shop at this store every single day.
Blessing.
The only thing, I'm a little disappointed in the African section.
Yo, y'all. So disappointed.
Like Africa section. It was very stereotypical of the African American section. It went straight to Louisiana hot sauce and jambalaya. Like,
I think I got a glimpse of
that. That was crazy. I'm like, what? Is that okay? Wow.
I'm like that.
But again, maybe they don't have a lot of exports.
And that is true. Other countries
underdeveloped
come in
country.
And take Africa's resources.
So many things come to mind.
And
but
don't allow
that
Africa
was very
to
sad.
Export
I was very excited
many
to go in that section,
goods
but
of their own.
Hey, it is what it
with
is.
With their own labels
again,
and tags.
Again, I'll see you guys when I pick up the camera again.
These are just some notables, y'all. I thought these were like really cool. I tried to do my best with B-roll, but obviously you could tell it wasn't that smooth. I almost fell or tripped over my feet. And like in the meat section, seafood section, saw some shark, and I think that is a stingray.